Yeah, go in and pretend that you're going to do melee. And then stand in the light. This is the way you do it. I'm not shot, I'm shot not.
I knew they would lure the servants of Satan, but I set this type of the archfiend himself! Where is La Croix?
Oh, that guy, he senses love.
Perhaps when La Croix runs out of minions, he will show me his face, and God will guide my shots through it! Before I send you to eternal damnation, any last words?
I guess not. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it, because a friendly, polite young tomcat just decided to have this episode. So, okay, I think I have to do something about Mr. Buck right now. He's up there. I have a sniper rifle, but my ranged combat skill sucks. So I can try to shoot him from here. But I think this is not going to work very well. Nope. Also, he's in there. Where's he? Don't even see him, so he's run away to do something else. Oh. Oh. Can we do something about him? Like that? Saving. Oh, jeez. He's a better shot than me. But it seems to work. I love AI exploits, really. Oh, can't obfuscate myself. Okay, here we go. Show your face! Do you guys really think that I'm pronouncing English in that way as that guy? He has supposedly a German accent. I don't know. I don't think so, but who knows, perhaps I do. And you know it better than I do. Come on. I will show my face now, and you are dead. So this would be the place to get the sniper rifle from, and a katana. Looks quite dead. Okay. That's him. I like the sniper rifle because it deals a really massive amount of damage. And that is nice. Even if I can't snipe properly with it, because I suck so badly, but it still deals a lot of damage. So, flamethrower. Flamethrower? So, wait, I found this uber weapon. The stay or stay rogue thing, which deals a lot of damages, has an auto-fire mode, and I love it. Because of Jagged Alliance 2, I love that weapon in there. And a flamethrower, which is definitely a good thing against vampires, because vampires hate fire. But it has a limited amount of ammunition, a very limited amount. So let's see what we have here. A dude.
I told you everything. There's no reason for you to keep me here. Let me go!
A speech on the sarcophagus. Speech, speech, speech.
I guess if you can get all the way here, you deserve the answers. But can I make one request first?
Yep.
After I answer your questions, you help me escape.
Yeah, I can do that. Yeah.
All right. Where should I begin?
Tell me a story about the sarcophagus.
Let's start with the history of the Ankaran sarcophagus.
Mm-hmm.
That is a long and interesting legend, lost and found throughout the ages. Tell me, are you familiar with the Assyrians?
Vaguely. Very vaguely. I love their work, though.
Yeah, well, the markings on the sarcophagus seem to hint that it is from sometime between 1050 and 800 BC, which was a period of fierce expansion by the Assyrians. Oddly, for those years, only one king shows up on the historical record.
Really? This one is listening.
While most likely he wiped all evidence of his predecessor's existence or passed the name to his heirs, one monarch, Mesarach, the one-eyed king, is given credit for the territory and achievements of this time. But he would have had to have been over 250 years old, like Dracula or something.
This is not that bad. There were ancient Assyrian kings or Sumerian kings who were supposedly even older than that. But let's not go in there. Mesarach or someone else?
I find it hard to believe a sarcophagus with a person as important as Mesarach could remain in, what is the word, pristine or intact condition for so many years. But this is who is believed to be contained within.
A real vampire? Really?
You know, it is interesting that you ask me that. The goddess on the outside of the sarcophagus was Lamastu. In Assyrian myth, Lamastu was an evil demoness who preyed on humans. Many people cite her as the mother of vampire myth, and...
Maybe I should look her up in the internet.
The engravings on and found around the sarcophagus portray a regal figure drinking the blood of his enemies. Now, this image is found in many cultures, specifically among those of royal lineage. But there is a quite scientific explanation.
And that would be?
A disorder known as porphyria. In short, it is caused by a deficiency of the iron in the blood, and in many cultures, for the nobility that could conceivably get away with the cure, the treatment was to drink human blood.
Shouldn't they just eat more livers or so? But he knew the sweet ecstasy of wait. He drank blood?
Perhaps. Drinking the blood of your enemies is, if nothing else, symbolic. It can inspire fear in your foes and dissidents. Don't misunderstand me. I in no way believe it was a vampire. Vampires. That's what caused this whole mess. These maniacs believe they exist.
Why did you discover it? The sarcophagus, I mean.
That is, you see, in archaeology, one can spend years looking for a dig site, following local rumors, studying old maps. It's a complicated process, very boring.
This one is listening.
Finding and organizing a dig is the least interesting part of an archaeologist's job. Trust me, you don't want to hear about it.
Interesting, but I'm interested. You are lying.
I don't know what would make you believe that. I have been very forthcoming with you so far. I think that maybe you are not as familiar with the process as me.
It called to you? No, it wrote you. The sarcophagus wrote you a letter, right?
Okay, I tell you, yeah. I was not even aware of the sarcophagus' existence until I received a package with no reply address in the mail. Inside was the information on how to find it and the key. Please keep it a secret, or I could be ruined.
And the key. So Messer Ruck is inside, without any doubt.
That I can't be sure of, nor can anyone. But I promise you it is more likely to be filled with, gummy bears than vampires. Perhaps maybe a mummy, but not likely the kind to go about chasing Abbott and Costello.
Can you tell me another story about vampires?
Not much, really. I'm an archaeologist, not a mythologist. But I do know that Lamastu, the Assyrian demoness, was thought to have been the inspiration for Lilith, the first wife of Adam in the Jewish Old Testament, another source of the vampire myth.
Okay. I think this is all I can ask him. I found it interesting. So, no more stories. I want into the sarcophagus.
Ah, quite interesting.
Yeah.
There is a surprisingly complex mechanical lock on the face of the sarcophagus. By sheer luck, we were able to find the key not far from the sarcophagus. Why no one ever found it and robbed it? It's perplexing.
You just told me that the key was mailed to you. I want it and I can't wait for Christmas.
How strange, you would ask. I haven't seen the key since it was loaded onto the Elizabeth Dane in Turkey. It was stolen before the sarcophagus even.
Mm-hmm.
I am still hopeful that the police find both pieces before the contents can be disturbed.
Where's the spare key?
No, it's not the kind of key you can copy at the hardware store.
No.
It's actually very sophisticated. And I meant to study it at the museum. I've answered all your questions. Do you think now you could please get me out of here? I don't care who you are or why you've had so many questions about the sarcophagus. I just want to leave this place.
Yeah, sure. Let's go on a cruise together. Just you and me.
Thank you, my friend.
Sure.
I don't know where you came from, but I will never forget this kindness.
Don't mention it. Or better, do mention it. Give me a good reputation. Okay. Yoink. This guy will increase my fame now. Okay, so I'm low on blood. Dude, you're still alive.
My attachment is here.
He set off the bomb. I just suppose that Johansen is right behind me. Nice.